Bump maps are the most common mapping type used within 3D modelling to simulate textures on a surface. Manually creating the model's surface detail can take a lot of time and lower the system's performance. Whereas bump maps are able to automate the effect for you and create smaller file sizes. As well as bump maps, there is also another method known as normal mapping. What's the difference? A normal map uses RGB values used to represent a direction of a texture, whereas a bump map uses either black or white, with white representing the higher areas and black the lower. Normal mapping is preferred within Visualize as it does offer a lot more control. You will be able to find normal and bump maps online from websites such as Polyhaven, but there may be an occasion where you are unable to find one suitable for your model and need to create one from scratch. Within this tutorial, we will be having a look at how to create a normal map within Photoshop and then applying this as a texture within a SolidWorks Visualize model. So let's go ahead and jump into Photoshop. I'm first going to create a new template for the pattern itself. I'm going to use a canvas of 100 by 100 pixels. I'm using a small size because the pattern will be tiled on a larger canvas later on. If you want the pattern for print, you will need to use a higher resolution and change the color mode to CMYK. Once happy, I'm then going to hit create. This will then take us into our Photoshop file. We first want to add two guide cursor reference in the center of our canvas. I'm going to hold down the control key and drag using my left mouse button from the ruler and add it to the center of the canvas, which should be about 50. I will create my pattern using shapes within Photoshop. I'm going to create a polygon with six sides with a width of 40 and a height of 80. I'm then going to place my shape in the center of the canvas using the guidelines to help. I'm then going to rasterize my image by right-clicking on the layer and hitting Rasterize Layer. This converts the vector layer into pixels and enables more editing capabilities. I'm then going to duplicate the layer, and then I want to create an offset for the new layer. I'm going to select this new layer, and then I'm going to go to Filter, Other, and Offset. You will want to add half the width and half the length of the canvas within the vertical and horizontal fields. For example, for this instance, it's going to be 50 and 50 for both. This is going to ensure that the pattern is going to be seamless when tiled. I'm then going to click OK, and then I'm going to merge the two layers together. We then want this to be added to the pattern library. We can do this by going to Edit, Define Pattern, and naming it accordingly. In this example, I'm just going to name it Test. This will then add your pattern to the library. I'm then going to test my pattern and create a normal map. I'm using a much larger canvas size of 1000 by 1000. It needs to remain a multiple of 100 from the original pattern size. This is so that the pattern remains seamless. Once done, I'm going to hit Create. I'm then going to unlock my background layer. I'm going to right click on the layer and go to Blending Options at the top. Once open, I will then click on Pattern Overlay. I'm going to browse for the pattern and ensure that the pattern is on 100%. Your pattern will now display on the canvas. You are able to see that at 100% the pattern is seamless. I'm then going to open my pattern into a new window, and I'm going to duplicate that file. This is so that I don't lose the original created pattern. I'm going to go to Image, Duplicate. Once open, I'm going to rasterize the image, and then I'm going to start to create my normal map. To create our normal map, I'm going to go to Filter, 3D, and Generate Normal Map. Within this pop-up, you will then be able to see a preview of our normal map and how this will affect a 3D object. There are also several settings available for you. On the top right-hand side, you will have the option to invert the selection, as well as blur and detail scaling. When changing settings, you will notice it will change in real time within the viewport. You are also able to see how the normal map would be affected in different lighting environments, and also show how the map would behave differently on different shaped objects. Do play around with the different settings, and once happy, press Export. We then want to save the image as a JPEG. To To do this, I'm going to go to File, Export, and Export As. I'm going to save using the relevant settings. Here, I'm just going to leave it all as default, and then I'm simply going to press Export. I'm going to save this into the relevant location. Here, I'm just saving it into the default Visualize folder for textures. I'm going to rename it as Test, and I'm going to hit Save. Once saved, I'm going to go and open Visualize. I'm going to select the appearance that I would like to apply the texture to. In this example, we will be adding it to the appearance that is currently applied to the handle, dense rubber. I'm then going to make sure I'm within the Textures tab, and I'm going to click on Bump. Here, I'm then going to browse for the normal map that I created, and I'm going to click Open. Then you'll be able to see that the texture has now been applied to the material. Under the Textures tab, you'll also see three different types of mapping types. Not only do we have Bump, but we also have Color, Specular, and Alpha. You may be wondering what all of these mean. Color represents the overall color pattern of an appearance. Specular represents the intensity of highlights of an appearance, normally with black and white. Alpha is used to create perforations within the model, with black representing material being removed and white areas to be kept. Under Texture Mapping, you will also have the option for the Texture Mode. This allows us to alter the way the texture is applied to the model. Here, I'm going to set mine as cylindrical due to this being the closest shape of the handle itself. I'm then going to go back to my Textures tab and adjust my texture accordingly. Here, I'm just going to adjust the tiling slightly, and I'm also going to change my depth to 0.3. You should then see your texture change in real time when changing any settings. I'm then going to go into Accurate Mode as well, just to see my final result. You can save any appearance to your Visualize library. You are then able to access these within any Visualize project. I'm going to rename the appearance accordingly. Here, I'm just going to call it the Handle Texture. I'm going to go to the Export symbol at the top right-hand side of the screen, and I'm going to hit Save Appearance. Once open, I'm just going to save this into a relevant file location. Once found, you can just hit Save. And then if you browse within your library, within Visualize, you are then able to see the texture that you just previously saved. I hope you enjoyed this video on creating and applying a normal map to a SolidWorks Visualize model.